Last year, OnePlus blew away its mobile rivals to bag our Best Phone of 2016 award, and now in 2017 it's back with a sleek and shiny OnePlus 5, boasting a new dual lens camera and super premium specs. Here's our full OnePlus 5 review. So we're going to do a full unboxing now and set up and everything as well, so you can take an in-depth look at the new OnePlus flagship phone with us. So first of all, sorry if I kind of pass out halfway through this video. I did just get off a train that was about 300 degrees. So I'm feeling a little bit lightheaded. But the OnePlus 5 is also making me feel lightheaded because it looks amazing. Good segue, right? So here we go. This is obviously OnePlus's first 2017 phone launch, and it looks to expand on the brilliant OnePlus 3T, which was our favorite phone of 2016. In several areas, most notably the dual camera, which as you can see, they've obviously bigged up quite a lot. There's the full reviewer's guide there, explaining the new handset in full with all of its new features, design, and all the rest of it. Hey, cat action. Everyone loves a good pussy. Cheap joke there for the win. So there you go, so I'll go through that later. But here we go, the OnePlus 5. So as you can see, we've got the handset itself right here. And as you, if you're a OnePlus fan already, you'll notice that the box certainly hasn't changed in design much at all. It's the same box we know and love. A nice shiny white glossy finish, very subtle design, just the number 5 there, slightly embossed in the surface. Dual camera, clearer photos of course, so again, continuing that message on both sides with the awesome new camera tech. And it's the midnight black one! Get in! Yes! Win! So it comes in two colours. There's a kind of a slate grey version and the midnight black. The midnight black is the more beefy of the two, as well as spawning the sexier design in our own personal opinion. As you can see, created together with our fans, OnePlus fans are obviously very vocal and very smart, very clued up when it comes to tech and all the rest of it. I'd imagine there's a few watching now, so good on you guys. So there we go, there's the OnePlus 5 handset, and also in the box it looks like we've got some of the new cases. So as you can see, you've got the wood grain finishes, just like you did on the previous OnePluses, and also a sort of a more textured sandblasted kind of finish, and that looks like another sort of textured banded effort there. So we'll check all those out in full, most likely in another video. But now, onto the main event, OnePlus 5. Here we go, let's do a full unboxing. So it's still a 5.5-inch handset, still a full metal unibody, as you'll see in a second, once I pull it free. There we go, there it is in all of its glory. Gorgeous, and very black, as you might expect. We'll take a look at that in a second. First of all, because it's an unboxing, we'll check out the rest of the box. Okay, so that's very snazzy. Straight away, you get an example photo taken on the OnePlus 5, shot by Gunkala Tixeria in Iceland. Sorry if I completely mauled your name, Gondera, as I probably did. So as you can see, a bit of Type-C USB action, and as usual, a lovely vibrant red cable. You're not gonna be losing that one in the dark when you're fumbling around at 2 a.m. because you're sloshed and you need to charge your phone back up. We know what you're like, you dirty sods. 3-pin UK plug, hooray. And of course it's fully dash charge compatible, as you can see, for the obvious clue on the side there. So that should power you back up. They're running a full day's charge in just 30 minutes, I believe it was. So hopefully that will provide just that kind of performance. And that's it in the box, nice and straightforward, no headphones or any other shibaz? That's not a word, is it? Sorry, again, my brain is melting in the heat. I'm not used to this, I am northern, as you might have picked up from my twang, so definitely not used to any kind of sun or anything like that. Now the OnePlus 5. So as you can see, about the same sort of size as the OnePlus 3T and the rest of it. There was talk of them potentially trying out, you know, a more of a bezel-free design and all that kind of thing, but that would have just ramped up the cost unnecessarily. So instead they've stuck to a more sort of traditional design, but made a few lovely little refinements all the same, which we are going to cover ready now.
Although this is the most slender OnePlus handset to date at a shade over 7 mm, that sleek metal frame hasn't changed too much. It's still a comfortable to grip 5.5-incher that's reasonably easy to operate one-handed. Ooh-ah. Those edges are pleasingly curved, so no sharp bit should ever dig into your flesh. Plus, that aluminium finish is tough enough to resist scratches and hides greasy prints really well. Just a shame it isn't water-resistant to boot. We're pleased to see a midnight black model available from launch as well, as this was one of our favourite finishes of the 3T. You can also get a less exciting slate grey version if that's your bag. Beneath the OnePlus 5's display, that ceramic fingerprint sensor is housed, and as before, this is pleasingly responsive. Just tap your recorded digit at the sunken surface and you'll be straight into your desktops in a jiffy. Although the resolution hasn't been boosted up to a sexy bit of Quad HD, that Full HD panel still does the job. Visuals are still pleasingly crisp, whether you're surfing the web or kicking back with some Netflix. Colours are quite punchy, viewing angles are solid, and on top brightness, the OnePlus is positively retina searing. Of course, there's no support for HDR video, something that you will find on other phones like the LG G6 and the Xperia XZ Premium. So if you do demand the absolute best possible visuals right now, you'll have to look elsewhere. Once again, there's no micro SD memory card expandability, so you're stuck with a storage built into the OnePlus 5, either 64GB in the slate grey model or 128GB with the midnight black version. On top of Android 7.1.1, you get OnePlus's own Oxygen OS overlay. This hasn't changed a significant amount compared with earlier versions, although there are a few new little bits thrown in there. Customization is the key, as you can tweak pretty much every part of the interface and even personalize those hardware buttons. For full details on the new and existing Oxygen OS features, check out our full OnePlus 5 tips and tricks guide. When it comes to performance, the OnePlus 5 is definitely right up there with the very best of them. With the mighty Snapdragon 835 platform on board, everyday performance is stupendously quick. Apps load up so fast, you'll swear they popped on screen before you even tap the icon. You can happily multitask with two apps side by side with no signs of fatigue. And of course, you get a generous choice of either 6 or 8 gigs of RAM, with the more generous measure packed inside that midnight black model. The Snapdragon 835 chipset is pleasingly efficient too, and both Android Nougat and the new Oxygen OS offer plenty of resource management tucked away in the back to extend that longevity. For instance, the battery optimization feature automatically restricts the background activity of any apps, unless you otherwise specify. You of course have a battery saver mode on board as well, for those really tough times when you just desperately need to wring out a little bit more life before charging. With typical everyday use, I got well over a full day per charge once the battery had settled. Even with quite intensive use, the OnePlus 5 will happily last you the full day. Dash Charge is once again on board, which powers up the OnePlus 5 to near full capacity in just an hour, while the handset remains ice cool throughout. Definitely no worries about long-term damage. So, onto the biggest change compared with the old OnePlus 3T, namely that dual lens snapper that's now neatly tucked away in the corner. You get a 16 megapixel f1.7 aperture lens, as well as a second 20 megapixel f2.6 aperture lens, which combine to capture crisp, detailed photos. On the main camera interface, you'll find a handful of simple toggles. You can quickly alter the aspect ratio of your photos or the resolution of your videos, for instance, as well as switching the HDR mode and the flash on or off. Switching to video mode is just a case of swiping your finger up the screen, or alternatively, if you swipe down the screen, you'll open up the new portrait mode. This is a fresh new option, using that dual lens setup to capture your subject in crisp detail. More on that later. As well as recording up to 4K resolution video, you can shoot time-lapse and slow motion footage on demand. And of course, you also have full manual controls via the Pro modes if you're confident enough to give them a whirl. This also comes with the option to capture raw images if so desired. OnePlus has included a couple of methods for quick loading the camera app as well, even when the phone is hibernating. For instance, double tap the OnePlus 5's power button and you'll jump straight in, ready to take a shot in just a second or so. So on to the good stuff, what is the photo quality actually like? Well, despite costing less than most of its rivals, the OnePlus 5 holds up rather well. With reasonable lighting conditions, we were very happy with the sharp results of our test photos. Even fast-moving subjects are captured without blur, helped by the nippy shutter action. Colours are realistically reproduced, with vibrant hues giving a particularly punchy and eye-pleasing photo. Accuracy levels are on par with any other mobile shooter out there, while in low light the OnePlus 5 actually outperforms some of its closest rivals. As for high contrast situations, they're handled well also. You can expect reasonable amounts of detail on any subject shot against a bright sky, without too much oversaturation of those brighter areas. Macro shots are also handled admirably. Again, expect solid detail levels while the lens rarely struggles to focus, even when mere centimeters away. As for that portrait mode, we're impressed by the results. You get some pleasing bokeh effects with no effort at all, while your subject stands out nicely in the shot. And you also get a 1.6x optical zoom as well, courtesy of that secondary telephoto lens. That's obviously not as strong as the zoom on the iPhone 7 Plus, but it's still better than you get on most other smartphones. The OnePlus 5 is perfectly fine for everyday home movies, packing in plenty of detail and coping well with sudden changes in lighting. However, there are some issues which definitely need addressing. For one, we found that the focus occasionally pops in full HD resolution, which you can see in this here test clip. It's a very distracting issue, and hopefully one which OnePlus can fix in an update sooner rather than later. Also, while the digital image stabilization does a good job of eliminating pretty much all judder and shake, the end result has a mechanical feel. It's almost as if a cyborg were shooting the footage, with smooth and sudden shifts in perspective. Not a serious problem by any means, it's just rather different from the results from other phones. In 4K resolution, our OnePlus 5 video results were definitely more impressive. You get loads of incredible detail and accurate colour reproduction for a pleasing viewing experience on the big screen. And that focus pop issue strangely seems to be no longer present either. However, image stabilisation is pretty much non-existent at this resolution, as there's no OIS and EIS isn't able to stop the judders. In other words, you'll need to stand perfectly still while recording, otherwise it'll look like your video was shot during an earthquake. Around the front of the OnePlus 5, you get a 16-meg selfie camera, which is just as impressive as the one on the OnePlus 3T. You have smile mode to activate the shutter automatically, with a time delay of course, a screen flash mode for low light shots, and of course the obligatory beauty mode to smooth out those creases. If you take a lot of ego stroke and selfie snaps to share online, this is well up to the job. The OnePlus 5 is absolutely stuffed to the gills with nifty features and software, and here's our full tips and tricks guide to show you some of the best bits, old and new. OnePlus 5 shelf shortcuts. Like previous OnePlus phones, the OnePlus 5 comes packing the company's shelf feature, which can be called up with a quick swipe right from your main desktop. The shelf once again offers quick access to the things and people that you love the most. To add a new widget, just tap the plus icon at the bottom right corner, followed by widget. You can add a wide selection of stuff, including Spotify controls, glimpses of recent activity in messaging apps, social network feeds, and so on. These widgets can be rearranged by pressing and holding on one until it pops free, and then dragging it up or down the list. Release it, and you'll also have the option to remove it entirely by tapping the cross icon. App shortcuts on the OnePlus 5. If you press and hold your finger on the recent apps button when you're inside of a supported app, you'll pull up a handy shortcuts menu. For instance, in YouTube, you can beam a chosen video to your telly, share a vid, or even check out your general settings. Want to disable this feature? Well, just head to your desktops and once again long press that recent apps button. Tap settings in the menu which pops up, and then tap app shortcuts to turn it off. You can also configure this from within the gestures menu inside the main OnePlus 5 settings. How to use the OnePlus 5's alert slider. On the left edge of the OnePlus 5, you'll spot the nifty alert slider, which can be shoved into one of three different positions. At the top position, the phone will be in silent mode. By default, this mutes any media and ringtones, although the phone will still vibrate to alert you to any incoming messages. Tap the cog icon which flashes up and you can alter these settings. In the middle position, the Do Not Disturb feature is activated. This blocks messages as well as calls from all but your starred contacts and anyone who tries to call more than once within a 3-minute period. Again, you can change these settings as well as add and remove starred contacts by tapping that cog icon which pops up onto the screen. In the bottom position, the phone will ring normally for notifications and not block anything. How to customize the OnePlus 5's navigation buttons. Head to the settings menu and tap buttons, and you can customize the touch navigation buttons right beneath the screen. By default, the one on the left is back, and the one on the right opens up a list of your recent apps, but you can swap them around within those settings. Or you can even bring up an on-screen navigation bar instead. From here, you can also assign shortcuts to each button, including the home button, when they're long pressed or double tapped. How to split screen multitask with two apps at once on the OnePlus 5. Back inside that buttons menu, you'll find that you can assign shortcuts to each of the back, home, and recent apps buttons. One of these shortcuts allows you to activate Android's built-in split screen mode, which allows you to use two apps side by side. Choose which shortcut you wish to use to activate split screen mode. For instance, you can assign this to a long press of the recent apps button if you like, which is the Android default anyway. Now just open the first app that you wish to multitask with and perform your chosen shortcut gesture. The screen will immediately split in two and you can open up another app to use at the same time. OnePlus 5 gesture shortcuts. As usual, this OnePlus handset comes with lots of quick action gestures built in. For instance, you can access the camera in a jiffy simply by double tapping the power button, even when the OnePlus 5 is hibernating. Head to the phone setting menu and scroll to the gestures section and you can activate a lot of other shortcuts too. You can flip the device to mute any incoming calls, for instance, or even wake the screen with a quick double tap. You can also play or pause music with a quick swipe of two fingers. OnePlus has also added the ability to open apps direct from the hibernation screen simply by tracing a letter with your finger. For instance, draw an O and you can jump straight into anything you like, although you will actually need to scan your fingerprint in addition for most features. How to use the OnePlus 5 reading mode. One of the brand new OxygenOS features packed away in the shiny OnePlus 5 is that new reading mode. This uses the ambient light sensor to automatically adjust the display's color temperature for a more comfortable viewing experience based on your environmental conditions. The idea is that it presents a more natural reading experience, kind of similar to an e-reader like the Kindle, definitely handy if you're going to be staring at that phone screen for an extended period. Enter the OnePlus 5 settings menu and then tap display and you'll see the new reading mode option stacked away in there. You can enable the feature for specific apps such as the Kindle app or just toggle it on manually if you want. how to change the vibration intensity of the OnePlus 5. Is the OnePlus 5's vibration function a little bit too violent or a little bit too soft? Well, in that case, just head to the settings menu and then select sound and vibration. Scroll down until you see the vibration intensity feature. And from here, you can choose the three strengths of vibration for three separate events: incoming calls, message arrival, and vibration on tap, which basically means when you're typing messages and so on. How to turn on the game and do not disturb modes. Head to the phone settings menu and scroll down to advanced and give that a poke. And in there, you'll find OnePlus's hidden game and do not disturb feature. As you might expect, this mode stops any notifications from interrupting your frantic gaming session and spoiling your rhythm. Oh, bollocks. From this menu, you can also lock the capacitive buttons so you don't accidentally quit your game with a random tap. And of course, you can also add which apps use the game and do not disturb feature upon startup. While the OnePlus 5 isn't quite perfect, it does offer a competitive flagship experience for less cash than its rivals. Killer performance, slick software, dependable photo quality, and plenty of extra smarts make for a great handset, as well as impressive value for money. For a full OnePlus 5 review, check out recombu.com/mobile, and don't forget to subscribe to that Recombu YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.